searching for the Godfather on Heat. And check out the ladies this week.
It's all about fun and good times with the Godfather.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from the Red Lake District, weighing in at 320 pounds, the Godfather.
It may not be easy, but it looks like fun, but it's not going to be fun for the Godfather once this match starts, because he's going one-on-one with Gangrel.
And we understand that throughout the broadcast here on Heat, there's been some conflict backstage between Godfather's ladies and Luna, who, of course, normally accompanies Gangrel. I got to wonder if Luna is going to be accompanying Gangrel, because the word we get from the back, Michael, is there's been some heated conflict.
Yeah, she may be a little hung up as this match starts. You know, Luna tried to persuade the Godfather a couple of weeks ago to become one of his ladies, so to speak, and actually tricked the Godfather into losing a big matchup.
And then last week, Gangrel tried to assert himself in a matchup against, that the Godfather had against Viscera here on Heat. Godfather wound up turning the tables, but the rivalry has been set over the past few weeks here on Heat. The Godfather very focused, but nonetheless, it's always about good times for the Godfather.
It's time once again for everybody to come aboard the... Man, let me look around. I know that I ain't the only one. Is there any pimps up in this house?
Kevin, will you sit down?
To all y'all that know that the Godfather be pimping hoes, man, don't hide it. I want you to take it out, light it up for the Godfather and say...
Well, there's something about black leather.
He weighs in at 250 pounds, Gangrel!
Well, there's Gangrel, but no Luna. What we understand, we're being told that Luna's been detained. Godfather's ladies actually found a way to trap Luna in her own dressing room. I wouldn't want to mess with Luna, not on a bet. She's a crazy woman.
And what mindset is Gangrel going to have in this matchup against the Godfather? Folks, just a reminder, coming your way in 2 weeks, Sunday, January 23rd, live at 1 a.m., it is the Royal Rumble, and it can be seen here exclusively on Channel 4.
And don't forget, Michael, that each and every week, you'll be able to see Heat at its normal time, 4 o'clock, right here on Channel 4. It's easy to remember. Channel 4?
At 4.
At 4.
We're whetting your appetite a little bit earlier this week as the Godfather goes to work on Gangrel. A huge rivalry in place here in our initial broadcast of Heat on Channel 4. So good to be on with Heat in the UK. Now these good fans in the UK know what they've been missing.
That's right.
Heat, a big hit in the States, going to be an even bigger hit in the UK. And folks, in the coming weeks, we're going to have all kinds of information about that huge event, which is coming to Earl's Court in London in May. We're going to have big information on that in the weeks to come here on Heat. I understand exclusive interviews, the whole nine yards.
Well, earlier you've heard comments from The Rock and Edge and Christian, and I know that World Wrestling Federation superstars love the fans in the UK.
I love going to the UK. What a trip that is. Godfather knocking Gangrel down. And here's the scoop by the ball. Look out. Look who has gotten loose. Look who's chasing the Godfather's ladies out of Dodge. Luna, Gangrel's love interest.
I'm telling you, she's crazy.
And look it. She's been defaced, apparently, by the Godfather's ladies, and she just chased him backstage.
Well, they smeared, looks like they smeared makeup all over her.
Gangrel DDT floats into the cover. Here's one, there's two, and a kick out by the Godfather before the count of three.
But once the Godfather saw his ladies getting chased out by Luna, he lost his focus for a moment. Gangrel able to seize control. Gangrel and Luna certainly are very gothic in there, and I don't mean gothic in the traditional sense, but they certainly lead a different kind of lifestyle, and it's somewhat dark. But, I mean, it's their way of expressing themselves. And a lot of World Wrestling Federation superstars love the freedom of expression that we in the States enjoy.
Well, Godfather's another one. He's made his living on freedom of expression. Gangrel whips the Godfather into the ropes. You're going to see a lot of that on Heat here on Channel 4. Cover. There's two. Kick out by the Godfather.
Boy, but there's no greater assemblage, I think, of characters anywhere else than right here in the World Wrestling Federation. And you new viewers to the World Wrestling Federation product, you'll be learning about them over the next few weeks, and we'll be explaining everything that's happening. Oh. There's so much news, and news moves so fast here in the WWF.
And coming up immediately following this matchup, for those of you who are new viewers, a look back at what happened in the World Wrestling Federation in 1999. For those of you who are veterans of the World Wrestling Federation, you're gonna love it. All the highlights of 1999 in our special year in review coming up on Heat.
It really was a remarkable year in the World Wrestling Federation. Michael, I would say that the year 2000 is being accentuated by the McMahon-Helmsley era, and I have to wonder what they have in store for us next.
You know, it's the old cliche, Kevin, to say that this certain group is the most powerful force ever assembled in the World Wrestling Federation. How many times have we said that? But in all honesty, if you look at Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley and Triple H, perhaps there has never been a more cunning, a more powerful group with everything in it together as this group.
Well, like you say, Michael, power sometimes is used as a cliche. But now that Triple H is the World Wrestling Federation champion, and with lives of the World Wrestling Federation superstars, I really don't think there has ever been anyone more powerful in the World Wrestling Federation's history.
Gangrel whipped off the ropes. Here he comes. Godfather. What a slam by the 300-pound Godfather.
And let's keep in mind that a lot of fans in the UK are, they know the history and the reputation of the World Wrestling Federation and all the great stars that you've seen over the year. But really, there's never been a greater roster of stars than there is right now in the World Wrestling Federation.
And you're seeing two of these great young superstars in the ring.
Uh-oh.
Look out, Luna. Godfather's in trouble here.
Oh, man.
Luna spewed that red liquid from her mouth inadvertently into the eyes of Gangrel as the Godfather ducked. And it's Ho Train time. Here comes the Godfather. Oh, my.
Luna tried to change the fortunes of the Godfather in this one, but instead has impacted Gangrel's life.
He calls it the pimp drop. If he connects, it's over. Godfather got it. Gangrel is going to pick up a loss in this one. Godfather picks up the win. And Luna is distraught.
Here is your winner, the Godfather.
Michael, we told him it was going to be wild here on Heat.
What a way to kick off our initial broadcast of Heat. Don't forget, next week, we will be at our normal time at 4 o'clock here on Channel 4. For Kevin Kelly, I'm Michael Cole. Thanks for joining us. We leave you now with a look back at the year that was in the World Wrestling Federation.